Victoria Beacon Hill.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Madam Speaker, when she was asked about the timing of the response to the Paige report last fall, the Premier said, and I quote, "The report was ready to be released. The children's advocates supported that release, so that's when it went out." Well, we now know, Madam Speaker, that simply wasn't true. An assistant deputy minister in government communications said in an email that, according to the Premier's office, Monday, October 19th, election day, was very much desired. And then he went out and told staff to do whatever it takes to get it out the door that day. What's clear from these emails, Madam Speaker, is that the Premier was calling the shots and the Premier wanted to play politics with this report. Honourable Speaker, my question is to the Premier. Why?
Madam Premier.
Thanks, Madam Speaker. First, if I can go back to the member did ask if we could go and meet with steelworkers. I challenge the members of the opposition to go out and meet with any union leaders around the province, all of the people to whom they want to deny jobs through their regular opposition to economic development in British Columbia, whether it's the steelworkers, whether it's the pipe fitters, whether it's a range of people from unions all across the province. They stand united in favour of jobs, and they stand united in getting to yes. I asked the member to go out and meet with the steelworkers and unions across the province and say, guess what? I've changed my mind. I suddenly believe in yes. That would be a nice change. But on the issue that the member has raised is vitally important. And I'm going to say this, because what the member talks about specifically is when the report was released. She talks about the day, the next day, when the minister made herself available to the media. Never once has this member gotten up and talked about the important contents of that report? Because surely that is the most important. Surely that is the outcome of that report is surely the most important thing to vulnerable youth in British Columbia. Yes, we have responded with immediate steps based on the outcome of that report. The rep called for a review of all the files for ministry-involved children and youth in the downtown east side. The minister put together a rapid response team. The rep called for accountability around agencies reporting harm and abuse. We have clarified the duty to report amongst those agencies. The rep called for making sure that the service delivery in the downtown east side was reviewed. Over a 5-month span, the ministry has been working and sitting down with social services agencies all around the downtown east side to make sure we clarify those issues. I know the member hasn't asked about whether or not this report has been followed up. She hasn't asked about whether or not the ministry is doing all that it can to respect the lessons that are learned from the tragic loss of Paige from this world, but I'm happy to inform the House and that member that this minister and this government is acting as quickly and responsibly as we can to fulfill the demands of this report, because those children depend on us.